Hi, this is Lynn from wisconsingarden.com, and today I'm finally getting to my avocado trees that have been growing in various pots, and I decided I was going to put them all in one pot. Yes, I'm going to be putting 3, 4, 5, 6 in this one pot.
So you're going to start an indoor avocado grove?
Pretty much. And I had to bring several of these in from outside. They've spent the summer on the screen porch, so now's the time. These have been in my kitchen, on my kitchen windowsill, for a long time. They definitely need to be transplanted. I am using this ceramic pot. It has quite a large hole in the bottom. And in order to keep my pebbles, which I'm putting some pea gravel in the bottom as a drainage tool, I'm using coffee filters to keep the pebbles from going in. Or falling out, rather, I should say. Okay, so I'm just doing a couple inches of those. Then I also have some vermiculite. Some people call it perlite. It's a mineral that's very light, and it keeps your soil nice and light in the pot.
Now, I noticed that you put pebbles down there, and I'm assuming that's for drainage?
Yes.
Okay.
That's for drainage. And it's
because you don't want your roots to be waterlogged.
That's right. Avocados do not like wet feet. They like to have moist and warm soil, but not soggy.
Well, that's one of the things we learned from Dave in California, who said the problem he originally had with his avocado trees, which produce fruit, was that he put them too deep into a clay soil. And once he realized that if he raised his trees up higher, that they wouldn't be waterlogged and basically die. So
right.
Now they're very prolific.
He was told by the avocado farmers that they even plant theirs on a hill so that the water flows past, but it does not allow the avocado to sit in the water.
So now you're mixing soil with vermiculite?
Yes.
And do you have a percentage or?
No, probably 2/3 to 1/3 of vermiculite. 2/3 potting soil. And I'm just using a basic potting soil.
So if you think of this as 2 containers of soil to 1 container of vermiculite.
Yes.
Okay. I just wanted to be clear.
Right. And the soil, this potting soil already has some in it. Okay, now before I fill it too much farther, I need to see what kind of root system, especially these have. These have been together for a long time, and their roots are coming out of the bottom. So I know some trimming has to be done here, if I can even get them out of here without creating a big old mess. I've loosened it up. Kind of like a cake, when you're taking a cake out of a pot. I loosened it up, and now I'm just going to use my old trusty fingers to see if I can get most of the roots. Oh, here they come. Oops, where can you grab that? You fight with me. There we go. All right.
Now, that wasn't too bad.
It wasn't too bad, except now I've got to fit these other 4 in here. Actually, there's going to be 7 in here. This soil, they've been outside all summer, and this soil is very cold. It's in the 40s today outside. Okay. Now I'll leave that one for last. This one, very tall and skinny.
Yes, it is.
Coming right out of the pot. You can see that the root has been cramped in there, so I'm just going to take off the toothpicks and maybe slide this one over in the corner.
Reminds me of a chestnut that the squirrels tend to plant all over the property.
Right, and these, oh boy, these are from Dave.
Our so these avocado. Are California's.
These are California ones from Dave's actual grove. Look at that.
Look at that root way, system.
My goodness. Too long since it should have been planted. Oof. Been happy on my kitchen window.
But that's so, not Dave, though.
This is one of Dave's.
Yeah, but that's not the one you dubbed or Dave. Called Dave.
The Dave is in your office.
Oh, that's right.
In the only southern window that has exposure.
Well, they are healthy, that's for sure.
I'm trying to make sure that I'm filling in underneath them so that there are no air pockets under there.
How about this first one that you put in?
That was pretty straightforward.
Oh, okay. Ooh, look at the root system on that beauty. Okay.
And that's what happens when you put soil in with your water when you're first starting them, because not only are these water roots, but they're soil roots. So it's much better for them because there won't be such a big transition now going to total soil.
Well, you don't just put them in water. You put vermiculite in with your water, right?
Either mixture? Vermiculite or soil. Yes, it depends on what's handy when I'm putting them in there.
So we're going to make a very delightful bouquet of avocado trees. Or should I call them bushes? I guess we have to call them avocado trees.
They are trees.
Yeah.
And the last one.
Look at that root system.
Where am I going with this one?
Probably over in this corner. Yep.
Okay, I'm just spreading out the roots a little bit. So, like again, I don't want any air pockets mixed in with the roots.
And then how much soil do you actually cover the entire the nut, so to speak?
The pit.
The pit?
The seed.
Seed? Whatever.
I'm going to put them about to the top of the seed.
Now, will the seeds eventually just decompose?
Yes, they do. Mm-hmm. Solid in there. Put a little more vermiculite in there.
It's like a bamboo forest.
Oh, avocado farmers would probably be having a fit.
Why?
Me just jamming them into this pot.
Oh, okay. Well, remember, this is for indoors.
That's right. We're not ever expecting to get any avocados fruits out of here. It's mostly so that we can enjoy the tropical greenery of them, knowing that at some point they were in a warmer climate.
Well, nice thing is you can trim them, and you know, as you trim them down, they'll just get stockier. Right?
They do to a certain point, yes.
Now, can you trim them too far that
yes.
would actually kill them?
Mm-hmm. I've done that. Yes. I have murdered avocado trees, not on purpose.
So what's the max or minimum you can cut them back and still have them survive?
That is a great question. What I do is I look to see where the majority of the leaves are. And like this one, if you had to get a little closer, this one was going way up this way. So I cut it here, and now it has this much growth on it again. I wouldn't want to take anything below or above, like right here.
At this point?
I need to have a couple of leaves that can still produce food for the plant. So if you cut it too far, it can't produce anymore. So
it wouldn't shoot off?
No. If it doesn't have any leaves, it seems to die.
Hmm.
Mm-hmm. Now I'm going to water this and see if I can snug them in just a little bit more with water. but I'm gonna have to put this in a pail because I need it to run all the way through.
Okay, well, maybe I can lift it for you.
Mm-hmm, and I've gotta go get one.
Okay.
Now that they're in and I have a tray here to save my furniture and rug, I'm just totally immersing the whole pot with water. This way it'll moisten the soil, but it'll also let me see whether I have enough soil in the pot to cover all the important parts. In the meanwhile, what I'm going to do is trim some of these leaves. Now, even in the best conditions, avocado leaves do get brown spots. I've learned that from Dave. And I'm just going to take these off. You wouldn't have to, but I don't like the looks of them. And inside, they're kind of crowded anyway. And then I'm also going to be trimming probably the very top off. I've topped this one earlier, but I think I can do it again because, well, maybe not that one. Well, that one's pretty scrawny. I don't think I'll try that one. Maybe this one. I do it right above a leaf. And this one, I'm going to do it right above this leaf, and this one right above here. Now, in our climate, this is winter, so they are not going to be having any sudden growth spurts. I think I'll also put in a stake, so at some point I could anchor them if I needed to. Like this one's trying to be wayward here. Maybe a little staking. Okay, let me see how it looks now. Push it down. I still don't see any coming out, no water coming out of the bottom. So I'm going to add more water. Now, in normal watering times, though, I would not have it soggy like this. This would be too soggy. They wouldn't like this. These probably I won't water for at least a week, maybe more.
Well, during the winter time, how often would you water?
Probably about once a week, depending on the soil. You'd always have to put your finger in there and see, is it soggy, or is it just moist, or is it dry? I would let the top for sure get totally dry before I'd even consider. I like to err on the side of a little drier than a little wetter.
Then too wet.
Right.
Yeah. And I notice no water is still coming out
the
bottom.
No.
So you must have a very good drainage system in there.
Well, I do have that several inches of gravel in there. So.
Yeah.
No.
Nothing's
coming yet. All right.
Well, just let it sit for a while and see what happens,
yep.
Right?
Mm-hmm. Well, that's it for the avocado grow for today. If you enjoyed the video and you found it helpful, please give us a thumbs up. And we'd love to hear from you, and we'd love to have you subscribe to us. Be part of our garden family. Thank you so much for watching. Bye for now. Come on. I know you want to dribble out.